Hey, what's up, Aquarius? Sun, moon, rising. Welcome to Spearitual Vibes Tarot, where it is my mission to impact you enough to know thyself. This is your June monthly reading, 2019. And right away, I want to tell you to go ahead and check that description box. It has all the information you need to connect with me, to reach out for your personal reading, just in case you need an extension regarding the messages that you're about to receive, or any other issue that you have, or, you know, just anything else that you want to know about your life. You know, as long as it's pertaining to you, I can help you with that. Just so you know, the readings that I conduct are day, month specific. However, we're all aligned differently. We're born differently. So these energies could have already happened to you. Some of this stuff may resonate with you already, and some of it is predictive. Okay? If none of it resonates with you, that means you're not in Aquarian energy this month. That means you're in another part of yourself. So I encourage you to get a natal chart for free at Cafe Astrology, I believe. And it will be super helpful if you know the time of your birth. You will get one that is more precise, okay? Now, this is a, 10, 12 card spread layout. So I'm going to go ahead and get to the messages because I only have so much time, like under 20 minutes. And now I've reached over 17. So yay! You got to really earn your keep on YouTube, y'all. So if you're ever in the mood, or you just feel upon your heart, or feel expressed, feel impressed, I should say, not expressed, but impressed, to donate to my channel, please do. It really helps. This is something I would like to do full time if I can, and your help or your contribution would definitely push me towards that particular endeavor. Now, with all of that being said, let's go ahead and get to the cards. Now, this month, your overall experience will be, and I'm happy to say, the Five of Coins. Yay! Relief. Relief, Aquarius. You're going to have some type of relief. Some of you, it will be financial relief. To some of you, it's monetary. So that's letting me know you're getting rid of some things. Yeah, and for some of you, you're going to be released, or you're going to find some relief in a third or three-party situation. Now, this could be work. It could be family. Yeah, I'm hearing shelter. For some Aquariuses, yes, your overall focus this month will be the Jack of Spades or Nines. Either you are concerned about a child in trouble, or some child that's been banned. I don't know if she's been, well, school is out here, so maybe they were banned from school, okay? Maybe they banned from the house. I don't know. This is a young child. Anywhere, I would say, from preteen, maybe to 18, 19. I can even say 20. That's for some of you. For some of you, you're focused on getting some prayer answered, okay? You're looking to somebody to open the door for you, or for some of you, somebody's getting out of jail, and you're gonna be focused on the regret. Yeah, you know, I'm gonna move on, and if source leads me back to this focus, I'll come back to it. But for some of you, you may already resonate with this focus, okay? Because it's May 28th today, so but your focus is definitely on somebody that's been banned. And I'm hearing the word smart. You know, maybe they're smart, or they thought they were being smart. Okay? Now, your expectation for the month of June is the Seven of Scepters. And I'm seeing some Sagittarian energy at work here. Maybe you are involved with a Sagittarian, but I see your eyes on a prize, on a goal, on something specific. For some of you, it's a dancer or a dance. I don't know. Some of you, it's a routine. Now, that routine could be in work. It could be a routine, like I said, in dance. And there's an opening for this. Okay, so I don't know what that is. Matter of fact, it's two positions open. Now, maybe this is a work aim. Okay, maybe some of you went and looked for work. Some of you are going to be looking at seeking maybe a top position. And you've been looking at this probably online. You've probably been looking at this on social media. And this is stemming from the Jack of Scepters or the Jack of Clubs. And this is a personal aim. I'm hearing hothead. I don't know what that means. Somebody got a hothead. I don't know if that's getting in the way of your goals or not. I hope it's not you, Aquarius. Sun, Moon, Rising. Now, I see somebody pigeon-toed. Maybe the person that's trying to fill the position, maybe that's a sign that they are pigeon-toed. Maybe you're pigeon-toed. And I'm hearing the word profit, like you're trying to get more salary, more capital for your business, maybe, for this endeavor. Yeah, you were very open about this too. You were open about this capitalization. I don't know if you talked to somebody, but you are really focused on this position, this top position. Now, again, there are two positions, entry level. Let's just say that I see them lower. But then I see this one position, you know. And for some of you, it's the back office. For some of you, it's a window. It's an office with a window in it, okay? So, I don't know what that means, but there you go. Yeah. But this Seven of Scepters is stemming from some personal aim that you've been very fiery, passionate about, okay? Hothead, passionate. You're very passionate about this. And for some of you, you need to cover your head. Maybe you got to, I don't know what that means right now. I don't know how to. I don't know. Maybe you just need to put on a wig. I don't know. Or maybe, with the capital, the money that you're looking at, like you want half of whatever it is or more. Yeah. you're being very passionate about achieving that. And all of this is based on the Seven of Cups, which lets me know that whatever this is emotional for you, and you've had several options. You had personal options for this Seven of Scepters. Wow. And your outcome, Aquarius, is the Seven of Swords, Seven of Knives. So you have 777 in your chart. Look at this. You have 777. That's some rest, some type of blessing in this. 777. You've hit a jackpot here from this Seven of Cups and this Jack of Scepters. Yes, that focus is giving you 777, and in the outcome, you're going to be meditating on what to say for this position, some of you. Yeah, you're going to be trying to figure out what to say. And you're going to be looking at details up and down, like you're going to really be detailed. Like, I see you in a meditative mode. I see you focused. And I see you really focused on these two positions, but that higher position is in your heart. So good luck with that. I hope it works for you. Now, your challenge for the month of June is the reverse Knight of Hearts or Knight of Chalice. That is your challenge. And your help will be the reverse Nine of Chalice. This is a lot of Scorpio energy. And you also have the... is that Pisces energy? Yeah, but your challenge is to come back with the offer, or to come back with I guess what I want to say, coming back with that belief. You know how you believe, you just know you're going to get something. And the challenge is to come back with that knowing with that certainty. I see some of you going to get a gold chain this month. Maybe that was important to you, but some of you went and bought. And I'm going to say, if you went and bought a chain and you're coming back challenged with this night, I need you to go check out the Pisces video, because this may be a connection. And what's going to help you, like I said, is this Nine of Chalice. And that is... first of all, you made up your mind to go after what you want. And some of you are overcoming something emotional this month, which is going to help you, you know. Maybe it's you're going to overcome it because of this position thing. Maybe that's sorted out. And for some of you, the fact that it's just over and done with is going to be helpful. You know, you're just glad it's over with. You don't care. Sometimes you get to the place, you don't even care what the outcome is. Just the fact that it's over, you know, that you don't have to be emotionally involved with it anymore. You don't have to think about it anymore is enough. And for some of you, I'm hearing lid and lift as part of your help. Okay? I don't know why that is, but it is. Now, your a message for the month of June. Spiritual Vibes Oracle Angel message is revolt, and that is reflected by the King of Spades or the King of Knives. Okay, revolt. Okay, so Aquarius, it's time for you to make a really dramatic change. And since you have the King of Spades or Knives, some say sword, you're going to have to develop or dramatically change the way you speak, how you present yourself, how you think about how you're positioned. And this could really mean like physically, because maybe some of you do social media work like I do, okay? But you're going to have to really, really change some things around and make it work for you. And my time is pushing, so let me go ahead. Your blessing for the month of June, you have another Spiritual Vibe Oracle Angel message. And it is the message of marijuana. And it is reflected by the death card. Some of you are going to be putting your foot in your mouth. Some of you are going to have two minds. Or there's going to be a split decision about marijuana. But once this is done, it's going to work out well. And I think that this is where this Nine of Chalice is coming from. Whatever this is right here, I'm feeling that. I'm feeling like this is connected to this Nine of Cups. Okay? So, I still see a rainbow. And I still see green. So, maybe you took a test and the person in charge is split about it. But... and she may be putting her foot in her mouth. I mean, she probably doing this. But nonetheless, I see a hand raised too. I don't know if it's because they're questioning something. I don't know if this is a confirmation, a count. I don't know, but let me move ahead. And your money message for the Spiritual Vibe Oracle is slang, and it is don't count your chickens before they hatch, and that is reflected by the Eight of Coins. And that's it with money. Don't count your chickens. You have a lot to do. You have a lot of obligations. You got things you need to finish up. So I don't know what you're thinking, but my best advice, based on don't count your chickens before you hatch, just wait and see what's going to happen, okay, when it comes to money. And with that being said, you all like, share, subscribe, and comment. And until next time, I'll see you again next month or next week. Peace, one love, take care.